So when it comes to a situation like this, when you're going to big games or the thing in Europe, and you look back at that 68 team and what you created after, particularly after Munich and that type of thing, you say to yourself, oh, it'd be great to equal that, to get to that point where people can say, they also won the European Cup. They're as good as the Mats team. Because he really set the stall about how this club should play and act, really. I think that they've had tremendous accolades for their performances over the last 2 years, and I think some of the football they've played has been unbelievable. It's the best side I've ever had.
They've had to spend so many seasons living on the memories of the Matt Busby era, but now under Alex Ferguson, the glory days are back at Old Trafford. United's fans have seen a succession of trophies rolling in, including last season, their first FA Cup and Championship double. Now, just one urgent ambition remains: to be champions of Europe. Hello, good evening. Welcome to the start of Manchester United's latest European adventure, which you can follow only on this channel. Between now and Christmas, we'll be bringing you all six of United's Champions League games, every kick live here on ITV. And I'm joined by a man who knows exactly what it would mean for the European Cup to come back here to Old Trafford. That's Dennis Law. Dennis, I guess it's the true benchmark, isn't it, of a club side and their manager to win the European Cup?
Oh, I think so. And the way that Alex is, the disappointment of last season against Galatasaray, which we thought that they would possibly win it there, he will be wanting to do that this season. And I think I would agree with him entirely that it's the best team that he has had under him, the double side, and I think they're quite capable of it.
Yeah, I don't think it's any secret at all. Alex would love to have the European Cup to go to what is a really a phenomenal record, isn't it? Not just here in England, but in Scotland, starting at Aberdeen.
Oh, phenomenal. He started off winning the titles with, as you say, Aberdeen, three league titles, four Scottish Cups. And, of course, that when he came down to England, everybody thought that he might have a, you know, it would be difficult for him. I think for the first two or three years it was, but then he won the title, then the double last season. And he's proved that he is probably one of the greatest managers ever to come out of Scotland.
15 major trophies is an extraordinary record in all.
It's not bad, is it?
We've eulogised, spoken highly of Alex.
Yes.
We would underestimate Gothenburg at our peril, wouldn't we?
Well, when you think that they've got seven from the World Cup squad in their squad, that they are going to be a very difficult team to beat. And we saw Blackburn play a lesser team last night and didn't play particularly well. So, no, I think that Alex will understand that this is a... the start of a campaign which has got to last a few months and got to be, you know, it's got to be difficult.
Let me pick out a couple for you, and I start with a goalkeeper. Surprise, surprise. He's got a face as animated as you.
I tell you what, I don't know. He's only 35. He certainly looks older than that. And I think typical of goalkeepers, they all look a little bit demented anyway, don't they?
Thank you, Dennis. But he's very close to breaking Peter Shilton's world record, so he's no mean goalkeeper, is he?
No, when you think he was voted second best goalkeeper in the World Cup in America, no.
Well, he's one of the older members, and Jesper Blomqvist, who they claim in Sweden is like Ryan Giggs, I'm not sure that's just true, but they've got to watch him.
Well, I'm sure. I watched Sweden in the World Cup. I can't really remember the lad, but this goal against Sparta Prague shows that he has a vicious left foot, and at 20 years of age, it will be certainly one for United to watch over tonight.
Yeah, there are some side to look at, but we're heading fast for the kick-off, and at this moment I think we can hear from the United camp. Let's join Gary Newbon.
Yes, behind me the team's ready to come out. One player who, of course, won't be in action tonight, Roy Keane, who's injured. Roy, the Swedish team really don't know what to expect as far as the atmosphere is concerned here at Old Trafford. What can you promise them?
Well, obviously I played in the European Cup last year against Galatasaray, and the atmosphere was fantastic. So hopefully the crowd can get behind the lads tonight and the lads can put in a good performance and get 2 points.
I mean, this is a different situation this time after the disappointments in Turkey. Here it's about getting league points.
Yeah, as you said, it's different now. And I said hopefully the lads can start off with getting 2 points and we can take it from there.
And a quick word about young 19-year-old Nicky Butt, who has to come in tonight.
Well, I don't think the manager's any fears about putting Nicky in. Obviously, Nicky's a very promising young player. And I think he'll enjoy tonight. And I think he won't let anybody down.
Thank you, Roy.
Okay. So there you see Alex Ferguson just going out in front of this Old Trafford crowd. You've seen the two teams go out, Manchester United and Gothenburg. Waiting for us in the commentary box tonight. I'm delighted to